Alright guys, welcome back. So, this is part 4 of the discussion, final part. My Bandwidth Prediction is going up today, so look forward to it. Well, the day that I upload this video. So, definitely going to be going ahead and just going over these final comments that I got and, discussing things, and hopefully if there's anything that sways my opinion on my Bandwidth Prediction, then hopefully it helps. If not, then I'm pretty much prepared to go ahead and put it up, so I hope you guys are looking forward to it. So, starting it off, we have a comment from Tiago. So Tiago, he pretty much gave a ban list, like a list. So, he has nothing banned. It's just fine, you know, it's understandable. Alright, so starting off, limited. Elemental Hero Stratos. I personally don't care if Stratos comes back. I'm not sure, if Konami wants to do it. This is pretty much Stratos' last chance to come back. Like, if Stratos doesn't come back this list, he ain't coming back. Because this is the opportunity for Stratos to come back. Him come back, promote the structure deck. So, if that's what you want to do, Konami, that's what you should do. I kind of feel like some things should get hit and brought down maybe to 2. Or, bring down if you're going to unban Stratos. Kind of feel like just unbanning Stratos and having, Stratos and triple Rota and triple Hero Layers and triple E-Call and triple Shadow Mist and, all that good stuff is a little bit too much. So, I think maybe unban Stratos and put some things down, I'm thinking. But, you'll get more detail about what I'm thinking about that and my banlist prediction. Right, next, Vanny's Emptiness. Yep. Scale Drain. But you have a dot dot. He put in like these asterisks on it. It's pretty much says equals to high chance of not happening. You really don't think Skill Drain will get hit? I mean, it's kind of ridiculous how this card Skill Drain has literally been going past list, pass. Like, you hit D Fissure Macro and Soul Drain because they're floodgate cards that hurt the game, and I'm in agreement with that, with you hitting those cards, Konami. But how can you, be totally, poo-poo on fucking D Fissure and fucking Macro and shit when Skill Drain and Vanities are both at 3? Like, that don't make no goddamn sense, but yeah, so if Skill Drain gets hit, then good. It deserves to get hit. If it doesn't get hit, then no surprise because Konami's a fucking idiot and they need to know that Skill Drain should not be at 3, no matter what. I don't care what the format is, I don't care what the deck is, I don't care what's topping, what's not topping. Skill Drain is not a card that should be at 3. And now, especially since Cleeplay have making that card relevant again in the meta, no. Skill Drain should not be at 3. Alright, next he has Tour Guide. He said maybe only go to 2. I agree. 2 is fine. 3 is a little bit too much. Fire Lake of the Brain Mist, I agree. 1. Shadow Fusion, I think that's a little bit too hard of a hit. So, you also put another asterisk, high chance of not happening, let me read what you said. Instead of Shadow Fusion, probably Window and Construct to win like the other Shiji did. Cleopords probably will not get hit this list since it just came out. Also, Anti-Spell Grains maybe get hit to 1 or 0, I doubt it. If Anti-Spell Great Spell Fragrance was relevant, and every single deck that was topping, that was being Cleopods were like, oh yeah, I just put in triple Anti-Spell Fragrance and just crush Cleopod, then I can understand. But no one has done that. At all. Like, no. That's not even a thing. Like, people will go with freaking Fairy Wind before they go with Anti-Spell Fragrance, so that's not even relevant. So, no. Alright, what's next? Sinister Shout again to 1? I agree. That's a fine hit. Artifact Morale Attack. I don't care if it's Morale Attack or Sanctum. I don't give a shit, but either one of them should be limited. Like, the Artifact Engine shouldn't even be a thing anymore, Like, OCG hit it, and they're the freaking liberal ones. Like, us here in conservative town, we should have heard that shit a long time ago. But I'm kind of guessing that Konami just kind of slipped their mind, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what goes through Konami's mind. Alright, so that's all his limits. Semi-limited. Dante. You only need one Dante, but, if you're going to do anything to Dante, you should probably limit him, just so you can't put Dante back with Dante and because if you put Dante to 2, then you're just going to go, okay, well, Dante, your effect, put the other Dante, and then that Dante, put the other Dante, and they'll just touch each other, so that's not even a thing. So, Dante should either be at 3 or at 1. There's no in-between. Mathematician Semi, I agree with that, You put that as a high chance of not happening, but I could see that, Generally, Konami likes to hit cards that, are sweeping. So by hitting Mathematician, then not only do they hit Shadows, but they also hit Burning Abyss, you know, indirectly, which, you know, depending on how they want to do and take that route, indirect hit is maybe like the easiest hit to go with. So yeah, I say Mathematician to 2 is fine, you know, and if it continues to be a problem next format, we can just head him down to 1. Simple as that, you know. All right, but let's just go ahead and try that too. All right, next, Unlimited Card Trooper. I doubt it. You know, the whole, you know, troop dupe scoop thing, it's still just no. You know, if you don't know, you summon Card Trooper and machine dupe it, summon 2 more Card Troopers, mill a whole bunch of cards, depending on what deck you're milling, you don't give a shit. You have 3 19 beaters, run over the hell out of your opponent, you have a limit removal, that is game. And then, of course, when destroyed, you get to draw 3 cards, so, you know, totally just plussing out the ass. So, yeah, troop scoop is definitely a thing, so I'm not a big fan of that. You know, we got, you got triple Curry Bandit, you don't need Card Trooper at 3 either. Alright, so, well, that's actually Tackle's first list. He actually has 2 lists, so I'll be going over that as well. But let's go ahead and go to that Chevon Henry? Chevon? I for some reason, I want to call him Chevy, but that's clearly not it. Like, Chevy and Henry is Chevy. Oh my god, it's terrible. Anyway, let's go ahead and go down what this person thinks. So, put Recliport, I don't know what that is, Cleport Assemblance and Cleport Scout and Summoner's Art to 1. Oh my god. Like, you just kicked this Cleport in the mouth so fucking hard. Like, no. That's not gonna happen. Like I said, I think the only things that Cleport are gonna get is an indirect hit with Skill Drain. Besides that, they're cool. They're not cool, but they're gonna be cool because, you know, that's Konami's, new cash cow thing, so you know that's their thing that they're gonna make a buck off of. That's the thing that they're trying to promote. So like I said, it's just gonna be indirect hits for them, you know, just like how Shadal's got an indirect hit with Super Poly, indirect hit. So yeah. All right, but God, like, is Assemblance even out? Assemblance isn't even out yet. Scout's like, wow, just killing deck. Summoner Dart to 1 too. Like, dude, like, I don't even know what Cleport is that like their field spell? I don't even know what that is. To make Cleport acceptable, throw their entire game to a screeching halt. Also ban trampolines. Want to make free Ragnazia? Yeah, I don't think so. So all of that. No. You're super butthurt, man. Super butthurt about the Cleport. Like, just deal with it. You just gotta buckle down and deal with it. All right, let's go down the rest of this. All right, artifact sent the 1. No need for hat running around. Like I said, I don't care if it's Sanctum or Monotype, just one of them needs to go, because the artifact engine is still a thing, especially since Cleport is starting to step up in power. The more powerful they get and the more relevant they get, the more powerful the artifact engine steps up, you know, with their Sanctums, you know, Monotype, some of them popping the ignitions, you know, it's definitely gonna hurt artifacts, so it might be smart for Konami to go ahead and nip that in the butt right now. Charger Light Brigade to 3 and JD to 1, consistency over power. There's no reason to adjust anything Light Swarm related. That deck is fine. Rescue Cat to 1. Hell no. I don't even know why you put that. Hell no. Rescue Cat is so fucking broken. You know what I'm gonna say? I'm gonna tell you right now. Rescue Cat is a 1 card Tiramisu. Yeah. You got Rescue Cat, tribute it, summon the Owl, summon Hootcake, summon the Kitty Cat. You just tributed the Rescue Cat to the graveyard. So, Hootcake, there you go. They're banished. Summon Messenger Law, search XC into Invoker, detach, summon whatever. XC, you know, detach, summon another Messenger Law, XC, bam, Tiramisu, right there. 1 card Tiramisu. Like, no. Like, Rescue Cat, it's literally just based on OTKs and loops and just a really unhealthy card. Like, no. Rescue Cat, stay banned. Sandgan 1, I don't care. Let's say Sandgan is unjustifiably banned, so whatever. Demok banned, too powerful early game, especially with Spoiler. Demok is banned. I'm confused by this. What do you mean? Demok banned, too powerful early game, especially with Spoiler. Alright, well, 1. Demok can come off banned if Soul Charge is banned. Because even in the hands of Spellbooks, why would they use Demok when world is so much better. Like, so much better. Like, anything that Demon can do, World can do 2 times better. Like, oh, when I'm summoned, I get to get us one of your spell books from the graveyard back to your hand. Like, ooh, like, I can get 2. And if I read 4, I wipe the whole field. Like, you know, no. Demok is fine. Like, you know, I just don't like the idea of just, like, you know, sending Demok to the graveyard, going soul charge, bring back Demok and a whole bunch of other shit, and then grabbing your soul charge back. I don't like that. So, if soul charge gets banned, Demok can come back. I wouldn't care. Alright, skill drain limited. Yes, I agree. The teller's got to do something about that before Diamond comes out. Maybe Delanova Alpha hit. I doubt it. I doubt the tellers are going to get hit. Tellers are slowly falling off anyway, you know. Like, what the fuck is Diamond to freaking Cleeput? Nothing. So, no, I doubt it. Tellers are, really, they're obsolete, but, you know, they're slowly getting cheaper. You know, they'll do something once in a while. That I'd say they're like deck number 4. You know, they're like in 4th place right now in the race. So, they're not even on the podium, so, nah. Rescue Rabbit 2 if Wyvern Fusion is banned. If Worm Fusion is banned, you mean that the first dragon guy? Like, Rabbit has nothing to do with him. Like, no. Like, he doesn't need to be banned, and Rabbit should just stay at 1. Rabbit's fun at 1. Vanity's banned. That's a little too extreme, you know. If they want to ban Vanity's, hey, more power to them, but I'd say 1 is fine. Bring back the baby dragons each to 1. Rulers are nothing but support. Might as well give disaster dragons full support. No. No. Babies are fine at banned. No. Babies are stupid. You know, they would just go, oh, my baby, you know, send another dragon, summon a D-Ruler from my deck, like, no, and then banish those 2 later, like, no, 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 babies are fine banned, dragon rulers are fine in 1, anything dragon related is fine. Next, Madoche Ticket banned, alright, I don't even know where the fuck that came from, but, no, like, Ticket's not even that good, like, no, no, if there's anything that, you know, that's powerful of the spell, it's Chateau. Chateau is way stronger than Ticket, so no. And that's on the brain so far. And I don't like this. I don't like this. I'm not trying to insult you, but you sound really salty and butthurt about a lot of things that aren't even relevant. So no. No, 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 no. Alright, so there you go. There's a Chevron Hendry's list. Alright, and then Tiago actually did another comment. So we're gonna go down Tiago's second list. So apparently this second one is a wish list, so no Cleeper cards because they came out this set. Alright. It seems like if you're gonna make a wish list, then you know, you can wish wherever you want. You know. It's kinda weird that you're restricting yourself on a wish list, but yeah, let's go with it. So ban, soul charge. I don't care. I know, I was totally a proponent of soul charge being banned. And I'm still not the biggest fan of it. Like, if Soul Charge gets banned, I wouldn't even bat an eyelash at it. But if it doesn't, then, you know, like I said, if Konami thinks that it's fine at 1, then, you know, I have no say-so. So, whatever. That's all I had to say about that. El Shaddaa Wunda. Wunda's fine. Wunda ain't shit. Wunda is not shit. You know? Wunda is strong. I'm just contradicting myself. Wunda is strong because, you know, if you could summon it first turn, you might, you know, seriously hinder your opponent's plays. But, you know, one of the most powerful plays, of course, in Shaddaa's is to be able to Shaddaa fuse from the deck, you know, with the regular Shaddaa fusion if your opponent controls extra monster. If your opponent summons stronger than freaking 22, then, you know, the only thing they can go into is Construct to handle that situation, you know. Especially if you can have something stronger than 26, because then not even Shikinaga can handle that situation. But, you know, it's Construct. You know, if Construct got limited to 1, and the deck would be different. Different, you know. Wunda's fine. Alright. Limited. Demok. Well, you banned Soul Charge, so I don't care. As long as you didn't bring back any other stupid spell cards, then I wouldn't care. Darkstrike Fighter. Darkstrike Fighter can go up to 3 for all you was shit. Like, he ain't shit. Wind Up Carrier Zemaiti. I doubt it. I doubt it. You know, Wind Ups have... The thing with Wind Ups is they've had their time. You know, they've had their day in the sun. You know? There's no reason to bring Carrier back. There's no reason at all. Why? You know? I mean, are they getting some support? Oh, excuse me. I'm not sure. I think they are, but I doubt it. That's not relevant enough. Yeah. Well, because saying like, oh, they're gonna bring back Carrier because they wind up getting support, like them doing bringing Mistari back up because Glad's got some new support. No, it really depends on how much hate Konami has, and I think Konami's hate for wind ups is pretty strong. TCG anyway. Next card, Heavy Storm. This card should come back because it is retard. Lose just for back row plus Starlight Road would be a thing, not just because of Heavy Storm, Darkhold, Regeki, but Fire Lake, and also kind of keeps doing Solemn Judgments for day, and you also have Dark Blood, and even be. No. I used to be a big old proponent of Heavy Storm, come out banned, but no. The game is fine without it. I'm not a big fan of how back row controlled the game is, but that's just the way the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Is. If you don't like it, then there's the door, but Heavy Storm coming back is not the correct choice at all. Especially when you brought back Demach, like Demach and Heavy Storm, I said no. Like Demach can't come as long as there's any stupid spells like that. No heavy, no Monster Reborn, no none of that. If you want to go summon Demach and grab a fucking Darkhold, then hey, more power to you. But nothing like heavy or anything like that. That's just crazy. Being like, oh, okay, well, I revive Demach and Demach grab heavy storm, my opponent heavy storm the whole field. Like, no. All right. Next, Dragon Ravine. I doubt it. Like I said, Konami is really a big stickler about if it broke, don't fix it. And clearly, whatever they did to address Dragon Rulers and make that not even relevant again worked. So there's no reason to even move any cards Dragon Ruler related. So no. Vanities, that should be at once. Goshen should be at one. Tour Guide. I said, I know this is kind of a wish list, but I kind of feel like Tour Guide to 1 is a little bit too extreme. I'd say 2 is fine. Fire Lake, I agree. It's not the first time that Konami is, gave you a card in the set and then hit it later. Like, Fire Lake is clearly unhealthy for the game. At 1, if you got it, you get it, but, not in multiples. No. Shadow Fusion, like I said, that's a little too far, but alright. I'd say 2 is fine. Sinister Shadow Game. So one, all right. Morale Attack, yes, or Sanctum. Castell. Castell is very powerful, if they decided to go ahead and limit Castell, I wouldn't blink an eyelash just because of how powerful the card is, Castell literally is just taking over so many damn jobs. Like, he put freaking Diamond Dyer, he put Black Ship, he put Mindstroke, he's fighting 101 for his job too, like fucking Castell's busting up here, and he's like, he took your job! He took your job! So, Castell is just like that, so. If they want to go ahead and put Castell down to 1, just so, everybody gets 1, I wouldn't really wouldn't care. Alright, Summon Limited, Torrential Tribute, nah. Torrential Tribute, they're all at 1. They're all fine at 1. Darkhold, Torrential Tribute, Regeki, all at 1. They're fine. They don't need to be any higher than that, Now, at that point, you're just making the game generally unhealthy, that just because destruction's not good in the meta, that you can just simply just unban all the mass destruction cards. Not everybody's playing meta. That would literally just make the bottom half of the game unhealthy. So I'm not a big fan of it. Torrential, Darkhold, or Regeki moving anywhere. Dante to 2, like I said, that ain't gonna do anything. Mathematician to 2, I wouldn't mind that. Alright, Unlimited, Cyberstein. It's a little extreme, don't you think? Maybe take it to 1 and test it? Glow Up Bulb, that's fine. Trigodia, no. Trigodia is way stronger than Gorge. Trigodia, too. Gorge at 3, I don't care. Card Trooper, I already explained that. Karzara Ban Heavy, Oratonia should unlimit Gorge. That I don't rate nothing because there's no reason to have. Okay, I don't understand what you're saying right there. Oh my god, there's a lot of reading. Doing shouldn't happen because the deck is old and Konami's not making money because. Also, don't come with the thing this shouldn't happen because the deck is old and Konami's not making money on it because. Or because what is banned, don't fix it. Does reasons are not viable. I mean, what do you want me to say? Like, what do you want me to say? Why should Konami give support to old decks that's not making money out of it? Konami is a conglomerate business. What's the point? What's the point of giving old decks support or bringing back cards for old decks? Why? Gale, that was obvious. Like, that was obvious as fuck with Gale. Like, there's gotta be a stipulation with it all, And, and the whole, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, I wouldn't say it if it wasn't fucking true. Yes, there's cards that are Dragon Roy that Konami can fucking move. Yeah, they could bring back Dragon's Reach. Yes, they can fucking up fucking Seven Stars, Sacred Star. But are they? I doubt it, because it was Dragon related. They hit it. The deck hasn't been relevant, so why change anything or even attempt to change or move anything and make the deck and make Dragon relevant again? That's not what they want. So, literally, I'm sorry that you're tired of hearing me say those two things, but they're fucking true. They are very fucking viable arguments, because it's fucking true. If it wasn't true, and I was just spewing shit out of my asshole, then I could understand you not taking it. But, yes, those are very valid reasons. I'm sorry that you don't like that, but, hey, what can I tell you? I mean, I don't work for fucking Konami, but, yep. Alright, well, there we go. So this is actually the final part, part four, final part. So Banless Tradition will be going up today. I'm going to be uploading at about 1:30. Yeah, 1:30 is a nice time. So I generally like to get my Banless Predictions up, you know, a whole month early, because, you know, people are going to be spending that whole month ahead, you know, searching up people's Banless Predictions, hearing people's thoughts. So I like to get my video up early and, you know, have people, you know, when they search it up, they find mine, they come to my channel, they watch it, they enjoy it, they subscribe. So, you know, a little bit of a publicity for me, no problem with that, right? So thank you for everybody who decided to go ahead and comment in this video. It was fun. I enjoyed doing these, sitting down and talking. So now we're just gonna step away from the Banless Prediction, and I might talk about other people's Banless Predictions every once in a while or something along those lines, but, you know, until the real list comes out, I guess we're just going to be waiting. We should get it sometime this month in December, so looking forward to it. You know, no better Christmas present than a ban list, right? You know, fuck running down the stairs and going to the tree. I'll run down the stairs and go to the computer and look at that ban list, because, yeah, that's what I want. That's what I want in my Christmas stocking, a good ban list. So, like I said, Banless Prediction going up, so look forward to it. So I know your guys' opinions now. I got your guys' 2 cents, so thank you for reminding me of any cards that I missed and giving me you guys' point of views. So I said tomorrow, Daily Duels, we're going to be using Teller Knights, and I will go over my experience at Anaheim. I've been pushing that back over a week now, and it needs to get done. It needs to get done. I need to get that off my chest, so look forward to it. Alright, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this 4-part. So thanks for watching, thanks for all the support, and I will see you guys in the Banless Prediction. Alright, thanks for watching.